stool mining Ethereum plus Kaspa. What is Kaspa and what do I need to mine it? Hello my fellow cryptocurrency miner, my name is Crypto Donkey Miner. What is Kaspa and what do I need? Kaspa is a proof of work cryptocurrency which implements the GoStack protocol, however that is not the most interesting part. The most interesting is that Kaspa is a community project that is completely open source with no central governance and no biz model. So no business model, we like that. Just like Bitcoin, Litecoin, Monero, Grin, and of course Kaspa itself. To mine Kaspa cryptocurrency, you need a wallet. Head over to wallet.kaspanet.io and create a new wallet. You'll also need a pool, so head over to kaspa.acc-pool.pw/getting-started. Simply copy-paste the region you want to use. You'll also need a mining client. You can use BzMiner if you want to mine only Kaspa, but if you want dual mining, get the latest version of LOLMINER, and then we'll configure it to mine Ethereum plus Kaspa dual mining or Ethereum Classic plus Kaspa dual mining. ETH plus Kaspa dual mining, HiveOS and Windows configuration. Simply add the following to the end of your extra config arguments in HiveOS or at the end of your batch file in Windows. You don't need hstat 200, I included it because a lot of people don't actually use it, and then when I get a screenshot of their miner, it looks like a bowl of spaghetti. So please include that as well so it looks good at least in the miner. How to trade Kaspa. This is where it gets a little bit sad. There are only two places you can actually trade Kaspa currently, txbit.io and xbittron.com. You can also trade directly with other people on their Discord channel if you want. Ethereum Kaspa dual mining overclock settings. Here you can see the overclock settings for the RTX 3050, RTX 3060, RTX 3060 Ti Hynix Revision 1, RTX 3060 Ti Hynix Revision 2, RTX 3070, RTX 3070 Ti, RTX 3080 10 gigs, and RTX 3080 12 gigs. All of them are using locked core clock. If you disagree with these overclock settings or you have some that are better, feel free to share them in the comment and of course include all the details like core clock, memory, etc. Thank you very much. Or just write angry messages on Reddit, especially the subreddit GPU mining. That is also okay. Ethereum plus Kaspa dual mining hash rates. Here we have the hash rates for LOLMINER 1.54 mining Ethereum plus KAS dual mining. At first glance, the Ethereum hash rates looks completely fine. They are a bit lower than they used to be, and the average power consumption looks to be a little bit higher. Let's compare the results with pure Ethereum mining. But first, if you're interested in learning C# programming that you can also use for Unity game making, then check out my new channel, DonkeySharp. Please help me out by liking the video and subscribing if you haven't subscribed. It actually helps out a lot. To the left we have Ethereum mining and to the right we have Ethereum plus Kaspa dual mining. As we can see, the average Ethereum hash rate is not really affected that much, but the power consumption does go up quite a bit. If you look at the RTX 3070, we see that it goes up 26 watts, which is quite a lot actually for an RTX 3070 card. The RTX 3060 Ti cards also have quite a jump, as do the RTX 3080 cards. While the RTX 3070 Ti power jump is considerably lower, which is most likely due to me actually running at a lower clock, and we can also see that it gives less Kaspa. Mining screen. All my tests were done in HiveOS using NVIDIA driver 510.68.02. I believe you'll get pretty close to the same results using Windows. The miner ran for 1.5 hours and the results are based on an average from 10 minutes in to the 1.5 hours. Of course, you can also dual mine with Ethereum Classic plus Kaspa. Let me know in the comments if you are interested in seeing Ethereum Classic at all. Ethereum proof of work ends soon and will go proof of stake very soon. What will you be mining after Ethereum 2.0? Let me know in the comments. That is all for this time. I hope to see you in the next one.